someone many of us have been blessed with. Others haven't been so lucky. In Daddy's Hands, we get to witness what it's been like for Rose growing up without her father. Daddy's Hands by Kenneth Hayes. My little Rose, the most beautiful thing to have, the most generous gift one can give, the most treasured symbol of love, and God gave me a life supply of it through you. My little Rose. Do you remember saying that to me, Daddy? I still remember. I never told you just how much that meant to me, but I'll cherish it forever. It's a beautiful day out. The sun is shining, the birds are chirping, and the grass is as green as ever. And long, too. Oh, Daddy, just look at this. You can't even read your name because the grass has grown so much. I do wish the yard help would take better care of you while I'm away. There. That does it. Your facelift is complete. But I guess that doesn't matter, huh? Things are pretty good with the family. Thomas Christopher is getting real big. He's right over there in the car. Can you believe it's been 3 years since he came into this world? He's growing up so fast. He's starting to talk up a storm, and he eats like a horse. His favorite food is fried chicken, of course, just like his grandfather. And he runs all over the place, trying to cause as much trouble as he possibly can. I need roller skates to keep up with him. He's a beautiful little boy. His eyes are just like yours, Daddy. I wish you were here to see him. His hands are just like yours, too. They're big and strong, but without all those lines and calluses. Remember that time in church when I was sitting next to you, and I was holding your hand, and I said, "Daddy, you're holy!" How was I supposed to know that the holes I saw were from broken blisters from a hard day at work? I was only 5 and I practically believed you were God himself, and I knew just how to prove it to everybody. Show them you were holy. Boy, did Pastor Jim ever get a chuckle out of that. Maybe he was just a little nervous that the congregation would ask you to start doing the baptizing. You would have been great if you had. I thought you were going to be so mad at me. But you just stood there and said to everyone in your gruff voice, "That's my little Rose." Oh, but I bet you remember that time you spanked my behind all the way down Main Street and into my bedroom. I admit, I might have deserved it, but you wouldn't let me go play with the other children. And the only way I could was to sneak out the back door. How was I supposed to know that you were going to the store right next to the park? You really felt bad, didn't you? I understood, Daddy. I really did. I really miss you, Daddy. I miss your hugs. I miss you patting me on the back when I did something right. And in a weird way, I miss the spankings I would get for doing something wrong. At least then I knew you were here. If you would just come back to me. This wasn't supposed to happen. You were perfectly fine that night when you went to bed. How can you just die in your sleep? There weren't any symptoms, no history, no warnings, no goodbyes. You just died. You were supposed to be here when I graduated from high school, when I got married, and when I had children. Your grandchildren. I was counting on you, Daddy. Where are you? This wasn't supposed to happen to me. It's not fair. father is. Why has God taken that from me? What have I done to deserve this? What about a life supply for me? Where's my gift? Oh, Thomas. What are you doing out of the car? I told you to stay there until I came back. Am I crying? Because Mommy's sad. Why? Because I miss my daddy. Where is he? He died and went to live in heaven. Oh, Thomas, come here. You don't have to cry. Come here. It's okay. My daddy, your grandfather, was the most loving man you would have ever met. And you know what? You look just like him. He was big and strong, with arms and legs made out of steel. He had snowflake hair and ocean blue eyes and a belly full of love. But the best part about my father was his hands. They were big and strong, yet so very gentle and caring. And you know what? They look just like these hands right here. You see those two lines in the middle? My daddy had those too. Except his hands had a few more wrinkles and calluses. But I don't think they were always like that. No, I don't suppose so. Why am I crying? No, I'm not sad this time. I'm happy. Why? Because I just realized something I should have realized a long time ago. You are my most beautiful